But I feel personally, this much of introduction about Napoleon would not suffice for the learners to understand who is Napoleon. So, with my personal interest, I would like to add Napoleon's biography and few details about Napoleon for the learners to have better idea about Napoleon. I hope you all will like this initiative. Napoleon Bonaparte. The full name of Napoleon is Napoleon Bonaparte, who was born in 1769 and passed away in 1821. In brief, if you have to tell about Napoleon in two lines, we can tell as Napoleon Bonaparte was a French military general who crowned himself the first emperor of France. His Napoleonic code remains as a model for government worldwide. This is in two lines, who is Napoleon Bonaparte? Napoleon Bonaparte is one of the French military generals who crowned himself the first emperor of France. His Napoleonic code remains a model for governments worldwide today. Who was Napoleon? History of Napoleon begins here. Napoleon Bonaparte was a French military general, the first emperor of France, and one of the world's greatest military leaders who inspires the world even today. Napoleon Bonaparte is one of my inspiring personalities. Napoleon revolutionized military organizations and trainings, sponsored the Napoleonic Code, reorganized education, and established long-lived concord with papacy. Napoleon revolutionized the military organization and training, sponsored the Napoleonic Code. In the early life, Napoleon was born in Ajaccio on the French island of Corsica on 15th of August 1789. Napoleon was the fourth and the second surviving child of Carlo Bonaparte, a lawyer, and his wife Letizia Romania. Around the time of Napoleon's birth, Corsica's occupation by the French had drawn considerable local resistance. Carlo Bonaparte had at first supported the nationalist siding with their leaders, Pasquale Paoli. But after Paoli was forced to flee the island, Carlo switched his allegiance to French, and after doing so, he was appointed as assessor of the judicial district of Ajaccio in 1771. A plush job that eventually enabled him to enroll his two sons, Joseph and Napoleon, in France College Theatre. That's how he got access to military education. Eventually, Napoleon ended up at the Military College of Brenny, where he studied for 5 years before moving on to the Military Academy in Paris. 1785, Napoleon was at the academy. His father died of stomach cancer. This propelled Napoleon to take the reins as the head of the family. Graduating early from the military academy, Napoleon, now the second lieutenant of the artillery, returned to Corsica in 1786. Back home, Napoleon got behind the Corsican resistance to the French occupation. Siding with his father's former ally, Pasquale Paoli, but the two soon had to fall apart. When a civil war in Corsica began in 1793, Napoleon, now an enemy of Paoli, and his family relocated to France, where they assumed the French version of their name, Bonaparte. Napoleon's return to France from Corsica began with the service with the French military, where he rejoined his regiment at Nice in June 1793. Napoleon's height. Napoleon stood 5 feet 7 inches tall. There are few assumptions and few theories which say that his height is 5'3, 5'4, 5'5. Whatever might be his height, making him slightly taller than the average French man of his time. Much has made of Napoleon's height, and legends claim that he was unusually short, giving rise to the term Napoleon complex, an inferiority complex sometimes associated with people of short stature. Some historians attribute the myths about Napoleon's height to British propaganda. Maybe. We are not sure of what his height is. Now, moving on to understand French Revolution. Why I added this part in this is that French Revolution needs to have the details of Napoleon, because both have gone simultaneously. So if you teach only one part, the other part would not be understood by the learners. This is my strong feeling. French Revolution, the turmoil of the French Revolution, created opportunities for the ambitious military leaders like Napoleon. The young leader quickly showed his support for the Jacobins, a far left political movement and the most well-known and popular political club from the French Revolution. In 1792, 3 years after the revolution had begun, France was declared as a republic, and the following year King Louis XVI was executed, what we all learned in the French Revolution. Ultimately, these acts led to the rise of Maximilian de Robespierre and what became essentially the dictatorship of the Committee of Public Safety. Now, the year 1793 and 1794 came to be known as the Reign of Terror, in which many as 40,000 people were killed. Eventually, the Jacobins fell from power and Robespierre was executed. In 1795, the Directory took control of the country and a power it would it assume until 1799, Napoleon's rise to power. After falling out of favor with Robespierre, Napoleon came into the good graces of Directory in 1795. After he saved the government from counter-revolutionary forces, for his efforts, Napoleon was soon named as commander of the Army of the Interior. In addition, he was trusted advisor to the Directory on the military matters. In 1796, Napoleon took the helm of the army of Italy, a post he would be coveting. The army, just 30,000 strong, disgruntled and underfed, was soon turned around by the young military commander. Under his direction, the reinvigorated army won numerous crucial victory against the Austrians, greatly expanded the French Empire and squashed an internal threat by the royalists, who wished to return France to a monarchy. All of these successes helped make Napoleon the military's biggest star of the time. Napoleon and Josephine. Napoleon married Josephine de Beauharnais, a widow of General Alexandre, who was guillotined during the Reign of Terror, and the mother of two children, on March 19, 1796, in a civil ceremony. Josephine was unable to give him a son, so in 1810, Napoleon arranged for annulment of their marriage so that he could wed Mary Lucy, an 18-year-old daughter of the Emperor of Austria. The couple had a son named Napoleon II, the King of Rome, on March 20, 1811. The Napoleon's role in Egypt. July 1, 1798. Napoleon and his army traveled to the Middle East to undermine Great Britain's empire by occupying Egypt and disrupting English trade routes to India. But his military campaigns proved disastrous. On August 1, 1798, Admiral Horatio Nelson's fleet decimated Napoleon's forces in the Battle of the Nile. Napoleon's image and that of France were greatly harmed by the loss. And in a show of newfound confidence against the commander, Britain, Austria, Russia, and Turkey formed a new coalition against France. In the springs of 1799, French armies were defeated in Italy, forcing France to give up much of the peninsula. In October, Napoleon returned to France, where he was welcomed a popular military leader. Napoleonic Wars. Napoleon is famous for his wars. The Napoleonic Wars were a series of wars of Europe from 1803 to Napoleon's second abdication of power in 1815. In 1803, in the part of raising funds for war, France sold its North America's Louisiana territory to the United States for $15 million, a transaction known as Louisiana Purchase. Napoleon then returned to war with Britain, Russia, and Austria. In 1805, the British registered an important naval victory against France known as Battle of Trafalgar, which led Napoleon to scrap his plans to invade England. Instead, he set his sights on Austria and Russia and beat back both militaries in the Battle of Austerlitz. Other victories soon followed, allowing Napoleon to greatly expand the French Empire and paving the way for loyalists to his government to be installed in Poland, Italy, Naples, Sweden, Spain, Westphalia. Now moving on to Napoleonic Code. Napoleonic Code was introduced on 21st of March 1804. Napoleon instituted the Napoleonic Code, otherwise known as French Civil Code, which parts of which are still in use around the world today. So the Napoleonic Code forbade privileges based on birth, allowed freedom of religion, and stated that government jobs must be given to the most qualified. The terms of the code are main basis for many other countries' civil codes throughout Europe and North America. French Napoleonic Code followed Napoleon's new constitution, which created the first consul, a position and which amounted to nothing less than a dictatorship. Following the French Revolution, unrest continued in France. In June 1799, a coup resulted in the left-wing radical groups, the Jacobins, took control of the directory. So leaving the further details, Napoleon, invaded Russia. In 1802, he was elected as a consul for life, and 2 years later, he proclaimed himself as an emperor of France. Now Napoleon invaded Russia in 1812. Which was devastated when Napoleon's invasion of Russia turned out to be a colossal failure and the beginning of the end for Napoleon. Hundreds of thousands of soldiers in Napoleon's Grand Army were killed or badly wounded out of an original fighting force of 6 lakh men. Just 10,000 soldiers were still fit for battle. News of the defeat reinvigorated Napoleon's armies, both inside and outside of France. A failed coup was attempted while Napoleon led his charge against Russia, while the British began to advance through French territory. With international pressure mounting and his government lacking the resources to fight back against his enemies, Napoleon surrendered to the Allied forces on March 30, 1814. Exile. On April 6, 1814, Napoleon was forced to abdicate power and went into exile on the island of Elba in the Mediterranean Sea of Italy. His exile did not last long as he watched France stumble forward without him. In March 1815, Napoleon escaped the island and quickly made his way back to Paris. King Louis XVIII fled. Napoleon triumphantly returned to power. But the enthusiasm that greeted Napoleon when he resumed control of the government soon gave way to old frustrations and fears about his leadership. Waterloo. On June 16, 1815, Napoleon led French troops into Belgium and defeated the Prussians. 2 days later, he was defeated by the British and reinforced Prussian fighters at the Battle of Waterloo. It was a humiliating loss, and on June 22, 1815, Napoleon abdicated his power. In an effort to prolong his dynasty, he pushed to have his young son, Napoleon II, named after, but the coalition rejected the offer. Saint Helena, after Napoleon's abdication from power in 1815, fearing of repeat of his earlier return from exile on Elba, the British government sent him to a remote island of Saint Helena in the southern Atlantic. For the most part, Napoleon was free to do as he pleased to at his new home. He had leisurely morning, wrote often and read a lot. But the tedious routine of his life soon got to him, and he often shut himself indoors. How did Napoleon die? Napoleon died on 5th of May 1821 on the islands of St. Helena at the age of 51. By 1817, Napoleon's health has been deteriorating, and he showed the early signs of a stomach ulcer or possibly cancer. In the early 1821, he was bedridden and growing weaker by the day. In the April of that year, he dictated that his last will: "I wish my ashes to rest on the banks of Seine in the midst of French people which I have loved so much. I die before my time, killed by the English oligarchy and its hired assassin." Napoleon's tomb. Napoleon's tomb is located in Paris, France, in the Dôme des Invalides, originally a royal chapel built in 1677 and 1706. The Invalides were turned into military pantheon under Napoleon. In addition to Napoleon Bonaparte, several other French notables are built there, including Napoleon's son, Eglon, King of Rome, brother Joseph, and Germain Bonaparte, generals Bertrand and Duroc, and the French marshals of Foch and Lactance. So this is a brief details about Napoleon Bonaparte's life, which I feel may not be tested for you in the examination, but should have an idea to understand the French Revolution clearly. Hope you understood my thought process in giving this additional information to you learners in grade 9. Thank you.